Hello everybody, welcome to my video. Today we are going to be talking about Love is Blind, which is a reality TV show on Netflix. If you haven't seen it,
welcome to Love is Blind!
The pods are officially open.
This would be an awesome story to tell our kids.
I met your dad in a social experiment where I was dating 14 other guys.
He's like, I'm sorry, what, Mom?
Have you ever been in love?
I'm not trying to sound conceited, but it sounds like all you guys are going after me.
Oh my God.
Faith is definitely important to me.
I'm not religious at all.
Did we have a sex talk yet?
Oh my goodness. This is rated R now.
There's something about your voice.
That's what everyone keeps telling me.
So you have 30 contestants, and basically they meet sight unseen, supposed to get engaged, and then they finally see each other after they get engaged. Then they have 2 weeks to decide whether they want to get married or not, and then they get married or not. So that's the show. I'm here to talk about Shake in particular, who is a contestant on the show.
I'll be Shake. I go by Shake.
Wanted to give my opinion as a married woman. Also on a side note, my husband is Indian. I don't think it's really relevant that I'm mentioning that, but just want to like give a shout out to Indian men. They're not all like Shake. I digress. I think I just want to start by laying like my background opinion on reality TV shows and the contestants who join them. This is all my opinion. You get a whole lot of people from different walks of life. So you get people who are joining the reality TV show who actually want to get married, right? In this case, for Love is Blind. And, you know, want like the idea of it being, you know, sight unseen, and you know that's their goal. They're there for good reasons. Reality TV show contestants always say that, I'm here for the right reason. They say that because there's a lot of contestants who are not there for the right reasons. And to get into detail, like a lot of people join reality TV shows just for the fame, right? They want to boost their Instagram followers or whatever clout they're looking for. That's why they've joined the show. And you also get a lot of like prospective actors and actresses who do like these small gigs here and there. And then they, you know, they apply for a reality TV show, they get it, but like they're just an actor or actress. Those are the kind of people you get, in my opinion, on reality TV shows. So here comes Shake. He's this guy coming in hot.
I love buying clothes for girls. Yeah, what's your size?
What the fuck?
And again, keep in mind the premise of the show is it's called Love is Blind. And the first thing he asks, like almost every woman he meets, is what size they are. One way or another, you know, he asks in different convoluted ways. That somehow get worse and worse.
Would you like working out?
Yeah, not a huge fan.
Really?
Yep.
Ooh, I get along best with individuals that do work out.
You know, he insults basically every woman. It seems like no one's really interested in him and they take him like a joke. And then he meets Deep D, who is this super sweet, like very smart woman who deserves much better.
Do you like being on a guy's shoulders?
Yeah, you're up for the challenge, you can pick me up.
Yeah, will I have trouble picking you up?
She gives him a chance, and even though he insulted her, like she took it very gracefully. I just don't get like Deep D. Why? Maybe she felt bad for him. Maybe she just wanted to give like someone who's her similar like culture and ethnicity a chance.
My name is Deep T.
So you're Indian?
Yes. Oh shit, how'd you know?
I'm Indian.
But here's my take. You know, you could find someone who is your same culture and background, without having to go with the guy who insulted you by asking if he could pick you up. But I don't think she realized like how bad he was throughout the show until it aired and like she watched it back. So obviously like there's more at play. Like
he's actually this like really sweet, articulate, sensitive, and fun, outgoing person.
Maybe he was funny and sweet and charming, and then they cut all of that out and only left in the parts where he was being a jerk. Back to Shake, basically at the reunion, says that like the show premise is dumb because like you can't fall in love that way and physical attraction is very important.
There's also certain criteria there that goes beyond the emotional connection.
But this show establishes
love is not purely blind to me.
And just to circle back, like if Jake knew that physical attraction was like extremely important to him, why did he join the show? For fame and clout, maybe. Also, when he met her.
Holy shit. Hi. Oh my.
I think he was overcompensating how he really felt. Like a lot of people who are doing these like reaction reviews are like, he was so attracted to her. Like, I don't think he was.
Oh my God, you're so beautiful. Holy shit.
Hi.
I think he was just faking it so that he didn't, I don't think he wanted to admit to himself. And I also think that he didn't want people to think that he was shallow. So he overcompensated and pretended like he was extremely attracted to her and then realized that he wasn't and then kept stringing her along. Why would he want to stay on the show and string her along? For fame and clout. I think that's what it all comes down to. And like, Shake is out here like hating on the show, hating on the premise of the show, thinking that all the contestants are stupid. But like, really what's stupid is you joined a reality TV show that you don't agree with the premise of just because you wanted to become famous, and then you hate on the show and its premise, posting on Instagram about how it's stupid and blah 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 blah. And it's just like, you got what you wanted. You joined the show to become famous and to get more Instagram followers. You became infamous, and maybe that's what he's mad about, and here he is, you know.
Guys, this is pretty sad, honestly. The people that are mad at me for the things I did or said, you guys are going about this 1,000 times worse than anything I ever said or did. Anything. Take a look in the
mirror. I feel like he's having a hard time admitting to himself. Shallow has like a bad connotation to it. Everyone's a little shallow or materialistic. I myself, you know, I buy clothes that I like because I want to look good. I have a husband that, like, you know, when I started dating him, I thought he was hot, and like that's why I started talking to him, you know. Like, that's okay. It's okay to be that way, but like, you can be more graceful about how you say it. And I think Shake just doesn't get that. Like, I wouldn't say that he's completely wrong in what he's saying. I just think he's arrogant.
I'm not attracted to all of you. Unfortunately, the only one I'm attracted to is Vanessa. And it, oh, you know, gosh. And I wish I wasn't.
He's not admitting his own faults, and then it just like makes everything seem like bullshit, you know? Like, just admit where you're wrong. Don't blame the people or the show. Like, it's you. You joined the show because you wanted to be famous and you knew yourself that, I don't know why I'm like scolding him, but you knew yourself that you don't believe in like meeting someone without, you know, falling in love with someone and marrying them without seeing them. So why are you mad at the show when like they were very upfront about that? I don't know. It's mind-blowing to me. And I feel like he could have just, like, when he met Deep Deep, been like, you know what? Love isn't blind. And I'm not that altruistic where, like, I can just fall in love with someone based off of their personality, even though I like Deep D and her personality. Future Nati over here. I just had a few honorable mentions, or I guess I should say not so honorable mentions of like moments of shake that I wanted to comment on. And so, not so distant future, it's been like a couple hours, so lighting might be different, but I had some things I wanted to say. Okay, I'm gonna say them. First of all, one thing that Shake says throughout the series is that he doesn't have this like animalistic attraction to Deep D.
I don't really feel that kind of animalistic attraction. And obviously, you don't judge a relationship by just one factor.
Not feeling the animalistic attraction I want to feel.
Like, it's just an awful way to put it. It's so cringy. Like, why can't you say physical attraction or intimacy, you know? Like, we just don't have that intimacy instead of animalistic attraction. Like, I hate the way he says that. Then he says it to his mom.
I'm just not feeling necessarily the kind of like overwhelming instinctual attraction or animalistic attraction that I would want to feel and that I've felt before in other relationships. And the interest.
Why did he say it to his mom? Oh God, it was awful. Like, can you imagine just going up to like your mom or dad and being like, yeah, I just don't have this like animalistic desire to fuck them. Like, my mom would just be like, I didn't need to know that. That's a bit of a TMI. He didn't need to say it on the TV show at all. He didn't need to say it to his mom, for sure. That being said, how much of their personalities do these contestants even get to know? Like, I feel like your lifestyle as a person is like one of the most important things, like whether you can like be friends, make joke, talk, and like small talk in a pod is very different from like what your lifestyle's like in the real world, like when you're working every day, what you do on your weekends, what you do with your spare time, what your hobbies are. Like, those are the things that end up determining whether your marriage is gonna last. Because if you and your spouse don't have the same hobbies and interests, you're gonna spend a lot of time without each other. You're gonna spend a lot of time separate from each other doing your separate things. And then you lose this attraction, which physical attraction is one, but there's also proximity attraction, which is just spending time with someone and being around them often. You become more attracted to them, and that's an actual like law of attraction, which there's like a whole list of them. Like, maybe I'll put them here if I find them, but you know, it's not all physical and it's not all just like conversational. There's a lot more to attraction, passion, and that kind of physical love and attraction and like lust doesn't last forever in a relationship, no matter how sexy the other person is to you. That will go away. Companionship is what lasts lifetimes and can carry your marriage. That's, again, my opinion. Okay, so I had to chime in real quick just because I was editing, and like as I was watching it back, I realized like all of this information I'm pulling from my sociology class in college, but it's essentially theory of interpersonal relationships. And there's like these little screenshots that I've pasted are just clips of the theory, like theory of like different types of love, different ways of attraction, if you guys are interested in looking it up. Just wanted to let you know. So yes, it's my opinion that I do believe in those theories. Not, they are theories. Okay. I guess those are all my thoughts. I think Shake is shallow, and that's not a bad thing, but he's arrogant not to admit it. And to blame the show for the premise of the show and, like, editing him when, like, at the end of the day, no matter how, like, sweet and charming Shake might have been off camera, I don't think it will, like, that any of what anything he could have done would make up for how big of a jerk he was. If I was in the pods and I couldn't see the person, they couldn't see me, and the first question they asked was, like, about how I looked and the size I was, I would immediately shut them down. What's attractive to someone is not always looks, but, like, their personality. And at the end of the day, if that's what the show is about, how could anyone fall for Shake?
It's nature, baby. We're animals. We're animals.
No, you treat animals. We're human beings.
That's all I have to say about the show. But if you haven't watched it, it's pretty boring, to be honest. But Shake is probably one of the most entertaining characters on the show. There's also a lot of other characters who are entertaining, like Shane and Natalie and Shayna, like their whole love triangle. I guess it was a love square. But if you guys are interested in hearing me talk more about Love is Blind, let me know in the comments and I will make another video about it. If you have something in particular that you'd like me to talk about, let me know. Don't come for me and don't come for any of the people on the show. I am anti-troll, anti-hate, like, bring positivity to the world only. Just leave these people alone. They're just human beings, right? Like, we're not perfect. You're not perfect. Like, you know, I've made mistakes in my life. I'm not a perfect person. Shake's not a perfect person. And that's okay. We are people and we can learn from our mistakes. And that's all we can hope for, is that we learn and grow and get better. Thank you all for being here. I hope you all have a great rest of your day and come back next time. I have no idea what I'm gonna film next. Bye.